A very good evening to all of you, and it's my great pleasure and privilege today to be in front of you delivering this keynote session on brands with purpose. The session that you saw just now, where we saw some fantastic, a fantastic story from Lifebuoy, I think is also in many ways a reflection of a brand which has a sense of purpose. And I think to my colleagues from Hindustan Unilever and Mindshare, I think that was a fantastic presentation. Thank you. My name is Harish Bhatt. I'm from the Tata Group, and I'm here to speak to you about why brands today need to have a sense of purpose. Sometimes, brands with purpose is seen as a buzzword, but over the next 15 minutes, it will be my effort to tell you how purpose always wins with consumers. So why do brands need to have a sense of purpose? Let's look at the context. Brands are coming under increasing scrutiny today. How many of you recognize this picture? You do? In the more recent picture, he was not in the seat. But the fact is that brands are coming under scrutiny because consumers have become much more aware and demanding. It doesn't matter if you run an online brand like Facebook. It doesn't matter if you run an offline brand like Tata. But brands are coming under increasing scrutiny by all stakeholders. Not only are brands coming under increasing scrutiny, consumers today are overexposed to media. If you look at this guy tearing out his hair, not only are you overexposed to media, you don't know how much of what you see on media is true, how much of it is fake, and that is creating new dynamics in how consumers are perceiving media today. In addition, consumers are becoming far more skeptical today. Consumers believe, and this is particularly true in the Western world, but I think also an increasing feeling in India, amongst Indian consumers. Consumers are becoming more skeptical, and they believe that businesses are more focused on profits than on the community. Look at the data. 56% of all consumers here think that companies that only think about themselves and their profits are bound to fail. 60% of all people think CEOs are driven more by greed than a desire to make a positive difference in this world. So there is an increasing feeling from all your consumers, whichever companies you're part of, that companies here are out to make more profits and not really to deliver value to the community. But that's not where it ends. Across societies, in India, in the US, in the UK, wherever you go, there is a growing sense of inequality in society. This is the inequality which has led to Brexit, which has led to Trump's victory, which has led to many social inequalities in India. But there's a growing sense that very few people are cornering all the wealth in this world. And there is growing inequality and a sense of that inequality which is causing a great deal of angst amongst various consumers. And then you also have consumers becoming more anxious. You have consumers becoming more anxious about stuff like pollution. Whether you live in Delhi today, you live in Bombay today, you live in any city, consumers are saying, is the air that I'm breathing good enough or is it not? How many of you have woken up to a fog in the morning and said, my God, what's going on? Consumers are becoming worried about climate change. We had some of the hottest summers here in Mumbai continuing right into October and November. And you had floods in Kerala and the Coorg. Unseasonal floods, and you have climate change which is impacting various parts of the world. Consumers are getting anxious about that. Consumers are getting anxious about women's safety. Big issue in India, but big issue in many other parts of the world as well. So number of reasons why consumers are becoming anxious time after time after time, and I'm illustrating this to give you the context for why I think brands need a sense of purpose. And finally, there are so many fault lines around us in today's world, whether it is the fault line between Hindutva, right-wing Hindutva, and the liberal left-wing, whether it's the fault line between rich people and poor people, whether it's the fault line between Brexit and the rest of Europe, whether it's the fault line between Trump and the Democrats in the US, the fault lines between China and the US on one side across the world, you have multiple fault lines arising in the world. Even in recent days, if you look at India, if you look at some of the Supreme Court decisions around some of our temples and what it has meant in creating new fault lines, which have arisen from nowhere around disputes. So these fault lines are also bothering consumers everywhere. So think about this. Consumers today are living in a world where they are more anxious, where there's a growing sense of inequality. There are many more fault lines, and consumers also feel that companies are out just to make profits, and CEOs are greedy for the expense of their companies at the expense of consumers. It is this context, ladies and gentlemen, which makes it very, very important for brands to have a sense of purpose. And brands need to have a sense of purpose. Anything that a brand does, anything that a marketer does, should be driven by consumer insight. This is the context in which our consumers are living today. And because of this context, there are four very important dimensions that I want to put forward to you. The first dimension, and even before I come to the first dimension, because of this context of anxiety, because of this context of consumers feeling inequality in the world and fault lines and so forth, consumers are seeking anchors. They're seeking a sense of purpose. And they're suddenly finding that governments cannot give them a sense of purpose. They're suddenly finding that other social institutions cannot give them a purpose. So is there an opportunity here for brands to convey that sense of purpose to consumers? This is the context with which we are faced. And there are four important insights that I want to put on the line with you. The first insight that I want to leave with you is that consumers today want to connect to a higher purpose. You may feel very passionately about gender equality. You may feel very passionately about, let's say, religion. You may feel very passionately about the need to keep a very liberal view about sexual orientation. You may feel very passionately about climate change. But you may not have all the time in the world to do something about these issues, because all of us are engaged in our day-to-day jobs, in running our businesses, in running our brands, trying to earn our livelihoods. Because of this reason, brands can help consumers connect with causes which they think are very, very important. Brands can help consumers connect with causes that they believe in. And I want to give you one example here of a brand from the Tata Group which has done this. How many of you in this room have heard of Tanishq, the jewelry brand? So for many years, I used to be associated with that brand and run that brand. So I'm very fond of it. But one of the things Tanishq has always done is helped young women in India connect with progressive causes. And let me give you one cause which was never spoken about in India till Tanishq helped do it, which was the cause of women's remarriage. And I just want to screen for you a campaign which brings alive how Tanishq helped consumers connect with that cause.
A wedding to remember. Tanishq.
So here's a campaign which spoke about a topic which was generally considered taboo in the Indian context. No one speaks about women's remarriage openly in India. But when Tanishq did this, and you may well ask me, should a jewelry brand be doing this? But when Tanishq did this, it helped a lot of young modern women relate to Tanishq and say, listen, this is the kind of mindset that I subscribe to. And from whatever we have seen, the results that Tanishq has delivered have only gone up since doing campaigns such as this. So it's not just a sense of purpose, but it's also the business results which the brand has been able to achieve. But connect is just one part of purpose. There's a second reason why I think consumers want to see brands have a sense of purpose, which I have called conserve. All of us in this room want to conserve resources. As Indians, we are very value conscious. We don't want to waste. We don't like wasting food on our plate. We don't like wasting electricity. We don't like wasting money. We are a very, very value conscious society. And the need to conserve resources is something that brands can enable consumers to achieve. One brand in the Tata Group, again, which has done this splendidly, the sense of purpose of conserving for a long, long time, has been a brand called Voltas. Voltas, about 8 years back, had a 7% share of the Indian air conditioning market. And Voltas is not in a market where it faces Indian players alone. It faces the biggies of the consumer durables world, Samsung and LG and you name it, all brands, Carrier, everyone is in air conditioners. Over the last 8 years, Voltas has increased its market share from 7% to 23% of the Indian air conditioner market and is the market leader in India today because it has steadfastly struck to the sense of purpose about conservation of energy. This is just one example of the 5D DC motor technology. It just means that air conditioner switches off at whatever temperature you want to set it and ensures that there is no energy wasted until the temperature is maintained in your room. But it's been a best-selling air conditioner from Voltas. But it's innovations like this one after the other, and Voltas has defined its purpose as bringing the most energy-efficient air conditioners to the Indian population, helping consumers conserve resources. They save their own electricity bills, but they also feel less guilty about using air conditioning, knowing that you're wasting less resource for the planet. There's a third reason. The third reason is not connect and it's not conserve, but there is a large segment of consumers in this world who want to commit themselves to a purpose. And many brands have leveraged this very effectively. Think of a brand like Nike. When Nike says, just do it, people who want to commit to fitness in their lives, people who want to ensure that they pursue a fit life, commit to that cause of just do it, and therefore they buy just do it. So I think commitment is very, very important. We have used this very successfully for some of our own brands in the Tata Group. For instance, I used to run a brand called Tata Tea, and many of you must have heard of a famous campaign called Jagore, which Tata Tea has been having on media. Just look at one example of Jagore, which was played just before the 2014 elections. And this campaign was all about very few women in India, many fewer women in India vote than men, and we wanted women to vote because 49% of the electorate of India is women, therefore power of 49. So we had this campaign going on board to get women's issues to the fore and encourage women to vote.
Oh, very cool show. Hey, show.
Kya hai, madam?
Pepper spray. Koi tumhare saath funny behave kare na? Straight in the eyes.
We all need one nowadays, huh?
Tumhe bhi apni safety ke liye kuch karna chahiye.
Hum kala tika lagate hain.
Kala tika?
Like wo buri nazar type.
Superstitions, yeah, that's very sad.
Kala tika lagane se kuch nahi hone wala.
Education problem, guys. Chodo na.
Actually, madam, educated logo ko bhi lagana chahiye kala tika.
Oh, really?
Excuse me.
Jagore, 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 jagore.
वोट किसी ऐसे नेता को दो जो हमारी सेफ्टी के लिए कुछ करे सबके लिए चाहे
हम औरतें 49% वोटर्स हैं अपने मुद्दों के लिए वोट करो 49 के पावर के लिए वोट करो टाटा टी गोल्ड
एंड देन वी डिडंट स्टॉप एट दिस वी सेड वुमेन शुड आल्सो पुट अप देयर इश्यूज टू अस एंड वी एज टाटा टी विल टेक अप दोज इश्यूज टू एवरी सिंगल कैंडिडेट इन द कंट्री एंड देन वी प्लेड दिस कैंपेन ब्रिंगिंग अलाइव सम ऑफ आवर सोप ओपेरा स्टार्स
हम औरतें अपनी सहेलियों से बातें करती हैं माँ से नानी दादी से बातें करती हैं
समाज और परिवार की बातें करती है
लेकिन अब इलेक्शन करीब है छोटी मोटी बातें बंद
अब बातें उम्मीदवारों के बारे में करें
उन सब से या फिर हमसे बात करें हमें मिस्ड कॉल दीजिए जांचिए कि आपके क्षेत्र के कौन से उम्मीदवार ने आपके मुद्दों को अपनाया हम 49% वोटर्स हैं पूरी जांच के बाद ही वोट करिए
सिर्फ बहु नहीं बहुमत बनिए
This campaign got more than 8 million women across India responding with their views on their candidates and issues. It went on to become a best-selling campaign. And you may ask, why should a brand of tea do this? It should do this because it's good for women to vote. It should also do this because when consumers see a brand doing this, they emote much better with the brand. Tata Tea is now the largest selling brand of tea in the country, competing with some of the major multinationals in the country. And this is one of the reasons why the brand has gone there. So I've spoken about commit, I've spoken about conserve, I've spoken about connect. But there's a fourth reason, which is clean up. A lot of consumers feel that brands like ours, any brand, whether it's a Tata brand, whether it's a brand from any other company, consumers feel that brands are delivering a lot of waste to society, whether it's plastic, whether it is electronics, whether it is, you know, all sorts of things which get junked. You don't like spoiling the planet for the future. And many consumers are saying, if you guys are bringing this waste, you better also be responsible for cleaning it up. We don't want a world which has gone bad. So recognizing that as a key insight, we have an electronics retailing chain in the Tata Group called Croma. which many of you must have shopped at, or many of you would know about. So in Croma, we started small bins in the store, encouraging people to come back and dump their old electronics, junk electronics, saying, we'll take care of recycling it in the most scientific manner so that it doesn't lead to waste anywhere. And those bins got filled up very, very, very quickly. So we then took this forward and created a campaign called eCare, We Help You Dispose. Today, if you call that number, Croma arranges to pick up your electronic junk from your home and ensures that it is disposed of in the most scientific manner so that the waste is not left behind on garbage fills. And this sense of purpose of cleaning up has again encouraged many, many more consumers to come to Croma and shop for their electronic needs at Croma. So keep all these four factors in mind. Connect, commit, conserve, and clean up. I think these are the four reasons why brands need to have a sense of purpose. But I want to close my presentation by talking about a group that I've been part of for the past 31 years, ever since I finished college, which is the Tata Group. And I think the Tata brand, all of you would be happy to hear, Tata is one of India's oldest brands. We are marking 150 years of the Tata Group since the foundation of the Tata Group this year in 2018. And we were set up by Jamshedji Tata, who said he doesn't want to set up a business group which only makes profits. He wants to set up a business group where the community is center stage. And he did something of business, and he did something very important to make this happen. He took 66% of the share equity of Tata Sons, the holding company, and gave it to Tata Charitable Trust. Even today, our ownership is 66% by public charitable trusts. Because of that very noble move of our founder, what have Tata Public Charitable Trust done each year? They use all the dividends that they earn from Tata companies to plow it back into society, creating institutions like this, creating India's best science university, the finest cancer hospital, the National Center for Performing Arts, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. Just this year, in the year which has concluded, the Tata Trusts have given out more than 1,000 crores for the creation of cancer hospitals and other community welfare initiatives in the country. And I believe this is what imbues the Tata brand with a sense of purpose. Because all the four things I spoke about connect. When you buy a Tata product, you connect to the community because some part of the profits of that product through the Tata Trust go back to the community. And I think in general, India knows about this. They know that Tata is a good organization which tries to do this. Commit. I think apart from the examples that I gave you of brands, within our own organization, I think there's a strong commitment to volunteering, which ensures that we go out and volunteer. And last year we clocked, I think, about 1.2 million hours of volunteering. Conserve. We go to some of the most remote locations of India and ensure that artisans' culture is conserved. For instance, this is a picture you see from Samvad, which is the tribal conclave that Tata Steel does each year, where they bring together all the tribes of that region and celebrate their culture for the future. Similarly, Tanishq conserves jewelry artisanship for the future, and I can give you many, many more examples of that kind. And finally, clean up, not just through Croma, but when we re-inaugurated our corporate headquarters a few months ago, we ensured it was a platinum green-lit building. So this is about the Tata Group and how we try to bring a sense of purpose, and I think this is the sense of purpose why we have lived on for 150 years. Brands can be very, very profitable and manage maybe 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 30 years. The average life of a Fortune 500 company is only 40 years. If a brand has to live, survive, and flourish for 150 years, you need to have a sense of purpose to the brand itself. And that's something I'd want to leave behind with you. Whatever brand you're part of, you may say Tata is a big organization, 150 years old. We are part of a smaller startup, smaller organization. Whatever organization you're running, whatever brand you're running, which of these four can you relate to your brand? Can you help your customers connect to a larger purpose? Can you help your customers commit to something which is important in their life? Can you help your customers conserve their resources? Can you help clean up some of the mess which our companies create in the world? Because if you do even one of these four, not necessarily all these four, I think your brand will end up with a good sense of purpose, which will not just keep you going and going, but which will also ensure your success, because consumers like good brands, and in the future, consumers are going to prefer good brands. Having said that, on behalf of the Tata Group, I want to thank you for giving me a very, very patient hearing, and I hope this will leave you with some thoughts for how you can inject purpose or enhance purpose in your own brands. Thank you very much, and I'm going to invite my colleague. Thank you. Thank you for a very patient hearing. I'm going to invite my colleague Sri Lakshmi Hariharan, Deputy General Manager from our Corporate Brand and Marketing team, to engage me in a small fireside chat for the next 10 minutes, asking me a few questions on this topic, and we'll also open up to a couple of questions from all of you.
Pleasure to be here. Incidentally, the Tanishq and the Jagore campaigns are some of my personal favorites, so loved seeing it here again. So Harish, I'll kick off with a few questions and then we'll open it up with the audience for Q&A. So one thing that struck me about the presentation is that many of you will recollect earlier this year, Larry Fink, who is the CEO of BlackRock, the world's largest asset manager, he wrote a letter to his CEOs, which was aptly titled A Sense of Purpose. And in that letter, and I quote, he says that companies best benefit all their stakeholders, including shareholders, employees, customers, and the communities in which they operate. Now, this is very, very similar to what you talked about when Jamshedji Tata set up the Tata Group 150 years back, where he made community as the center stage of business. So my question is, how has the Tata Group stayed true to its purpose over the past 150 years?
So that's a very good question. You know, staying true to a sense of purpose is challenging. To begin with, Sri, I think one fact is that our founder wanted the community center stage in business, and one very important move that he and his sons did is transfer 66% of the equity to charitable trusts. And that is written in the constitution of the Tata Group, that we are owned by the Tata Trusts. And eventually, 66% of our profits, therefore, through dividends, flow to the Tata Charitable Trust, which are mandated to use them for the community. So there are 7 Tata Charitable Trusts. Each of them are dedicated to specific causes. One is dedicated to healthcare, one is dedicated to education, one is dedicated to art and culture, one is dedicated to the water mission in India, and so forth. So that is one way that it has been hardwired into the group. That the community will always be center stage, and that has been helpful because I think there is that remains unchanged over the generations. The second thing, which many of you may like to think about, when we create a product or service within the Tata Group, one question that we ask ourselves is there some benefit to the community and the nation out of doing this? Of course, a product or service has to be very competitive. It has to be very profitable. We can't survive if Croma or Tata Tea or Tanishq or Voltas are not market leaders. We have to create products and services which are world class because we have to compete with the best companies in the world. But we ask ourselves, is there a benefit to the community? So some of the finest products and services that we have created, for instance, if it is something like Tata Salt, which 1 in 2 Indians consumes, the reason it's become very popular is that Tata Salt was the first brand that iodized salt in India and brought iodized salt to a country which was suffering from iodine deficiency. The reason that Tanishq has become so popular is that Tanishq brought transparency and purity into a market for jewelry which was rife with practices which were not exactly pure. So we ask ourselves, is there a community angle to the brands that we bring on board? And we try to tick that box whenever we launch a new product or service. The third thing, which I think is very, very important, is each of our companies, wherever it is, whether it's in Jamshedpur or whether it's in Mithapur or whether it is in Bombay or Bangalore or Hosur, we try to see what we can do for the community around us. And that is how a town like Jamshedpur or Mithapur or Munnar or, many, many towns which the Tata Group is part of have been born. And fourth, very important is every year we celebrate our founders' determination to the community. So every March 3rd we have Founders' Day. We sit up and say this is what his vision was and how can we live up to a founder's vision. And I think that's very important as well. Many organizations do that. Unilever does that, a Procter & Gamble does that. So living up to your founder's vision is also very, very critical to maintaining that sense of purpose.
So clearly purpose is there on brand and marketing heads' minds. So, and we've also seen a lot of purpose-led marketing of late. But we've also seen that these kind of campaigns have had varying levels of success. Some have been very successful, but at the same time, some brands have faced a backlash. So how can brands differentiate from being just another buzzword or being fashionable than to being to have a really meaningful purpose? Yeah.
So to begin with, Shri, that's a good question. And to begin with, I must say, not all Tata campaigns have been successful. I showed you examples of very successful campaigns. I can equally talk of campaigns which have not been successes as well. You know, we are human beings. We make errors. Some campaigns are very successful and some are not. But what are the key variables which have made campaigns successful and which we can learn from? One is, if you're doing something, if you're injecting purpose into your brand, make it meaningful. Let it have a contribution to your consumer. If Croma is collecting junk electronics from its consumers, that is meaningful to its consumers, because consumers are saying, okay, here is a good way of disposing of my junk electronics and not messing up the world. If Tata Tea is asking women to register to vote, the women who vote find it meaningful that there's someone who is helping me to register, ensuring that my name is there on the polling booth, taken care of, which Tata Tea has done through its Jagore website. So make it meaningful for your consumers. Don't only talk about it. If Voltas is saying we have the most energy efficient air conditioners, the air conditioners had better be energy efficient. Otherwise, no one's going to buy them. So when you have a sense of purpose, be true to that sense of purpose and be meaningful to your consumers. That's the first thing I would like to say. The second thing is, it should have some relevance to your category. You know, with Croma, picking up junk electronics and disposing of it is meaningful because Croma is an electronics retailer. With Voltas, energy efficiency is a meaningful purpose because air conditioners are energy guzzlers. With Tata Tea, you know, you wake up to a cup of tea and you wake up to your civic responsibilities. That's why Jagore has worked very well as a campaign. So with Tanishq's key target audience are young, modern, progressive women of this country. Therefore, taking up young, modern, progressive themes which are important to women is the right thing to do for Tanishq. So have a purpose which is relevant to your category. So for instance, it may not make sense for Tanishq to do an electronics disposal campaign. Or it may not make sense for Tata Tea to do an energy efficiency campaign. So there has to be the right connect with whatever category you are in, whichever category your marketers for. So these are two things I would suggest. Be meaningful to your consumers and have some direct connect with the kind of category that you're marketing. This is what would make the campaign successful.
So, Harish, you talked about several examples from the Tata portfolio which have successfully leveraged various aspects of purpose. You talked about Voltas, Croma, Tanishq, and Tata Tea. Are there any examples you can talk about from outside the Tata group which have successfully leveraged purpose?
Yes, of course, Shri. I respect a lot of work that many other companies do in this area of purpose. I respect a lot of work that Hindustan Unilever does. Hindustan Unilever has run a huge cleanliness and health campaign in India. You also already saw the example which the speaker before me provided about one Hindustan Lever campaign. But if you look at the recent campaign, Haath, Muh and Bum, which Hindustan Lever has again run about cleanliness and hygiene, I think it's a wonderful campaign of getting people to promote cleanliness and hygiene in their day-to-day lives. What Paul Pullman did when he was appointed chairman of Hindustan Lever is sustainable living campaign, and saying that brands have to increase sales but not waste any more resources of the planet, I think is a wonderful example of that. What Nestle have done with their Nani Kali campaign, which is the girls' education campaign in India, is another very good example of a purpose being injected into a brand by another brand. What Nike have done with the Just Do It campaign, it's just, apart from selling many more Nike shoes, it's made everyone aware of the fact that you can be fit and you can be aspired to be an athlete in your own life. You may not be an Olympic athlete, but you can be an athlete in your own life. That's a sense of purpose as well. What Starbucks has done with their commitment to coffee farmers is, again, I think, a sense of purpose which they have been able to bring on. So there are many, many brands in the world which have made purpose very successfully work for them.
So those are actually quite fabulous examples, and I think CMOs are quite convinced that a purpose-led approach is obviously beneficial. But one common refrain we hear from CMOs is that, how do I convince my CFO to invest in purpose-led marketing? So do you think too much purpose takes away from the commercial success of a brand?
Yeah, so how many of you are marketers in this room? of some kind, I guess mostly everyone. So I've been a marketer all my life. I started as a marketing manager in Tata Tea, went on to become the marketing head of Tanishq, and then ran the Titan and Fast Track business as the CEO for many years. You know, getting anything out of your CFO is not easy. Leave alone purpose or building brands with purpose, which is the way it should be. That's what a CFO is supposed to do, to safeguard, to ensure that the financial resources of your company are well utilized. But you know, the best thing that you can do with a CFO is show the CFO how injecting purpose into your brand drives growth and drives profitability. And these are not mutually exclusive. All the brands I showed you today, Tanishq, Croma, Voltas, Tata Tea, all started small. Today they may be large brands, but they started small, and we started investing in the purpose year after year in a small way. Okay, I was part of a global, you know, study called the Insights 2020 study. And one amazing result we found in that study is that if a brand has a sense of purpose, 80% of those brands outperform their competitors in the marketplace. The other survey that I recently remember reading, Shri, is something you showed me, that in India, 80% of all youth have said that if a brand is a good brand with some sense of purpose, we are more likely to prefer that brand. And I think this is growing amongst millennials in the country. They like to buy a good brand, they like to work for a good brand, they like to be part of a good ecosystem, because they're also searching for anchors in their lives. So the best way of doing this is to actually convince your CFO that a brand with a sense of purpose can also deliver more, and use many of these examples to buffer up your argument, apart from any market research or any consumer feedback that you yourself have in your categories.
Thank you, Harish. I think we are running out of time, so maybe I'll just quickly see if we have any audience questions.
So I'm happy to take one or two questions. I know we have virtually run out of time. Is there anyone who wants to ask anything on any of the examples I gave you, on brands with purpose, why you should do it, why you should not do it? Yes. Just tell me your name and where you're from, if you don't mind. It'll give me some context.
My name is Prakash. I'm coming from Bangalore. Lot of companies do this corporate social responsibility, some part of what you've been mentioning. And so I know a lot of brands who do it just for the heck of it. Say that, you know, you do this, we plant so many trees. For each thing we do this, we do that. No, so how do you differentiate between that and, you know?
Very good question. What's your full name?
Om Prakash.
Om Prakash. Very good question, Om Prakash. And, I can tell you for a fact, you know, I am from Bangalore myself, and Bangalore needs many more trees, but that's apart from the point. Too much concrete in Bangalore now, in Marthahalli and Whitefield and everywhere else.
A lot of people have turned up these days now for, you buy this, we do this.
Right. The origin of purpose, at one point, companies just used to take money and give money to charity. This is how the big philanthropic trusts of past were set up. Leave alone the Tata Trust, whether it's the Rockefeller Foundation, whether it is, you know, I can talk of many other foundations. So at one point, doing good to the community was all about charity. That moved to corporate social responsibility, or doing good for the community. So companies started doing things around their community. Some companies would maintain the neighborhood park. Some companies would, you know, provide some money for the local school in their neighborhood. Some companies would get more employment for people in their state or in their area. So that was community CSR, or community social responsibility. What I have spoken about is how to integrate that sense of CSR or purpose into your brand. So this takes it one step ahead. This is not CSR, what I have spoken about. Croma collecting junk and electronics, it's good community social responsibility. It's a responsible thing for Croma to do. But also, when Croma starts talking about it to their consumers, consumers also feel more like buying from Croma. They feel Croma is a good brand and they buy from Croma. So it is not CSR in some... CSR is good to do, and today I think the company's law mandates that every company spend 2% of its profits on CSR. But what I spoke about was not CSR, it is how to integrate purpose or community into your brand. And that you should do using consumer insight. Anything you do with your brand should be based on consumer insight. If your consumer is going to prefer your brand more because you do it, and it is also doing good to society, then it's like, you know, you are virtually looking at two different objectives and meeting both those objectives simultaneously. You're doing good to the community and you're also strengthening your brand. I'll take one more question. I think many more, but the organizers will have to tell me when to stop. Yeah.
So I have another question. Again, I'm from Bangalore. So
you're also from Bangalore?
Yeah. Okay. So I would love to understand when CSR is integrated with marketing, actually CSR getting converted into marketing, is it driving the sense of purpose, the very sense of purpose with which the CSR activity started?
So, you know, it will drive a sense of purpose if it is aligned to your category and brand. Like I said earlier, an electronics retailer can speak about picking up and recycling junk electronics. Okay, an air conditioning brand can speak about energy conservation. So it has to be integrated with the kind of category that you're marketing in. It can't be just anything that you do. It has to be aligned very closely. You may be an IT services company, you may be a soap company, you may be a snacks company, whatever it is. The sense of purpose has to integrate somewhere with that.
But where has to be the emphasis more? Towards the CSR activity or towards the marketing?
See, you have to bring it at a junction of the two. The best campaigns are at the junction of both community and what is relevant to your category. Okay, I pointed out the example of, for instance, Nike and Just Do It. Okay, is it good for people to become fitter? It is good. So what Nike is saying is good for the community or for people on the whole. Is it helping Nike as a brand? Of course it's helping Nike as a brand, because people see Nike as a brand which gives that fitness. So you have to bring these two together, and it's that the marriage of this that the magic of purpose happens.
All right. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Two more questions. Okay.
Hi, this is Sanjay from Oracle. I just wanted to ask you, I think Tata's has global aspirations, and you're trying to expand beyond India as well. Of course, you've expanded significantly. So do you think marketing with purpose will also work in other geographies?
So firstly, I think you're quite right. Tata's have been born in India, but now are present across the world. And all of us here who are Indians, I think Tata is I don't think we in the Tata Group own the Tata brand. I think virtually every Indian owns the Tata brand. This is how it has grown over the last 150 years, because there's a lot of love and affection for the Tata brand, which has been earned over 150 years, and we have to be very careful in protecting that for the future. But having said that, since Tata is now across the world, you're quite right, we have a presence in 150 countries now and about 7 lakh employees working across these 150 countries in the world. And there are also brands which we run outside of India. Jaguar Land Rover is a Tata brand, present primarily in Europe and China and the US. Tetley Tea is a Tata brand in many other countries. Even in those countries, the sense of purpose is very important. So when Tetley Tea sources its tea, and Tetley is a market leader in countries like Canada, UK, and so forth, Tetley Tea only sources its tea from rainforest certified tea plantations, where all labor practices, all fertilization practices are in line with what is required as per the, for a greener planet. And consumers prefer Tetley Tea because of that. Okay, one of the reasons that Jaguar Land Rover is investing significantly in, higher efficiency engines and in electric vehicles is because that is the kind of purpose that many, many people want in their vehicles for the future. Nike's Just Do It campaign was born in Europe. It was not born and in the US. It was not born in India and has worked equally well there. So brands with purpose, I think, work across the world. While I have spoken about all the four examples I have spoken about are India specific, that's because I know India well and the Indian consumer well, but my colleagues from those companies would have spoken equally well about what we have done in those countries. So it's not country specific, it can work anywhere. And actually the consumer skepticism of corporates is even higher in the Western world than it is in India. So I think it can particularly work well in some of the Western countries. I think I'm down to my last question.
Yeah.
Yes,
Hi.
Ma'am.
My name is Isha and I'm from InfoEdge. You mentioned that brands can add a sense of purpose. Brands would also maybe already have a positioning or, you know, something that they already stand for in the consumer mind space, which could be based on a completely different human insight. Correct. Or any RTB for that matter, like all, you know, your brands also do. Is there a benchmark when a brand is planning to invest in an initiative as well as its communication? Is there a benchmark, A, on the budgets, from your experience, if you could recommend something? Or if not on budget, then at least a certain amount of exposure to the consumer, for the consumer to register that brand as a brand with sense of purpose?
Yeah. So good question. See, the benchmarks vary from category to category. Okay, in FMCG, it's very different. In jewelry, it's very different. You know, between these categories, I can't give you a single figure because all this, it may vary from 1.5% to 8% to 9% of revenue. So I can't really give you a benchmark across categories at all. But what I would say is, more than the level of investment, it is being consistent. If you decide that this is your sense of purpose, or if you decide that this is the purpose that you will embed in your brand, let me assure you, it is not going to work like magic that tomorrow morning the customer gets up and says, okay, here is, you know, this brand XYZ, and here is its sense of purpose, so I'm going to buy it. All the examples you have seen have taken many years of nurturing. Jagore is a 12-year-old campaign. Tanishq started these progressive women campaigns more than 15 years back. Okay, Voltas has taken 8 years, like I told you, for its market share to go up from 8 to 23%. But it doesn't mean that we invested heavily in media every single year. We started in a small way. Because Tanishq also at one stage was a 150 crore revenue brand. Today it is a 14,000 crore revenue brand. But we started small. We didn't have, when I was the marketing manager of Tanishq, I had no media budgets. My entire media budget must have been 80 lakhs rupees per year. So we started small. And when we started small, we started displaying it in our stores. We started ensuring that every Tanishq bag has some leaflet in it, which consumers can read. We ensured that we only had it through Facebook and through our, you know, through our social media campaigns. So we started in a small way before going on to national television, which happened much later. So my recommendation to you is, the first thing to do is to have a very good discussion in the company and say, all of us are aligned to making this our purpose, whatever it is, because this is relevant to our category and this is doing good for the community. Once you have done that, if you have budgets, you can go large. If you don't have budgets, you can start small. But every step counts. And over the years, you will keep building and building and building till it gets into the minds of people. I think that is what is critically important. So once again, Shri, thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Harish.
Thank you for a wonderful interview. And thanks to all of you for a very patient hearing.